Hey, this is Eric. I'm going to talk about spatial joins in QGIS. Spatial joins, like any join, so any join is useful where you have two different layers and you want to map one of them using data from both, or more than two. You could keep doing this. But at its most basic level, a join is going to tie together the features from two layers in a GIS. And there are a couple of ways of doing joins, and one of them is spatially. So spatially, you join features when they overlap, basically. So the most obvious way to do this is if you have small polygons or points, as I have in this case, and you have larger polygons that you want to fit them inside. We could use any of these boundaries. I'm going to go with the city council districts, and I'll pull those underneath the schools. Yeah. So right now, the schools, if we open up the attribute table, they have things like the borough, the school name, etc. They do not have the city council district right now. So if we wanted to map the schools by city council district, it would be hard to do. So I'm going to join them, and when I join them, they're going to get all of the attributes from the city council table, but only for the council district that they are within, that each one is within. So let me show you how to do that. It's relatively quick and easy. You go to Vector, Data Management Tools, and Join Attributes by Location. The target layer is where you want the data to go, the extra attributes to go. I want them to go to the school points. And the join layer is where the extra attributes are coming from. So often, if you're doing this, you want the target layer to be the smaller things, the smaller features, and the join layer to be the bigger things. At least when you're doing it this way, when you're trying to move the attributes from the larger one to the smaller one. This is how you want to break it down. I'm going to browse, and I already have a file here that I'm going to overwrite, schools join NYCC. I'm going to replace it. And I'm only going to keep schools that are actually in a city council district. And I'm adding that to my map. So you see that we have two layers now. There were a few schools that must be somehow part of New York City schools that are actually outside of the city. It doesn't make much sense to talk about their city council district, so I remove them. You could keep them if that was useful. Okay, so the geometries are exactly the same as I think we've established. The only change is when you go to the attribute table and you scroll all the way to the right, it now has all of the attributes from the matching city council district. One thing that can be annoying is you get all the extra data that you don't necessarily want here. I will, for my sanity, go into editing mode and delete column right here and pick the length and area columns and delete those. So now we just have the council district. And just to demonstrate that we did, in fact, correctly join these, I'm going to, let me save it first. I'm going to style the schools according to the city council district, so I'm doing a categorized style by council district and classifying. And when I hit apply, they are indeed grouped by city council district. Cool. Obviously, or maybe not totally obviously, you probably don't want to make a map like this. It's a little ugly, and if you have the boundaries, you don't necessarily need to change the colors too, but maybe you're in a context where you don't have the boundaries, or you want to do some analysis based on which city council district they're in. That's more what you would use it for, not for making a polka dotted ugly map like this. Okay, but that's how spatial joins work. Hope that is useful for you.